Hey y'all, welcome to Adochie Cosmetic Designs. My name is Patina Adochie and happy Halloween, y'all. Yes.
So Halloween has passed this year, so I hope you guys enjoyed that. I did include the shorts previously, so if you saw that and enjoyed that, stay tuned because this just goes into more detail about how I put the looks together, especially, more focused on the disco look. But I do include some about the Aaliyah inspired gothic look. So, I'll show you a little bit of that, but mostly this will focus on the disco look, especially if you're wanting just to know how to do vintage 70s makeup in general, or if you want to do a look like this for a birthday themed look, or if you want to have some ideas for this upcoming Halloween. Also, I will have links in the description box for the outfit and the look in general, as well as timestamps if you just want to skip past this and go straight into, the parts that you want to see. So go and check that out if you want to skip through something or just stay tuned.
So the first look I did was like a dark gothic look.
Since I lost some of the main footage to put together the full video for this look, then I'll go ahead and throw it in here in this just so you can see the things that I got in preparation for styling, because I'll be doing more than just makeup and all that. I'll be trying to style my stuff too, so I really went all out for both of these Halloween looks. So just want to show you that, and I'll have links in the description box for both this look as well as the look that I'm about to show y'all today. This is the hair that I tried to salvage. So I did two strand twisted, some I already had. Red and black ombre nails, some lashes, a little bit longer than usual, but they look like they should be cute. Don't laugh at my little snake, y'all. Yes, the resolution video had a snake in there. I'm trying to make this snake work. Some garter fishnet stockings, they look dope. This black tutu that wrap around, that should be cute. This black leotard or whatever with the lace there. The Victorian Gothic looking choker with the earrings and the gloves and everything. That should be cool. Shoes that ain't wore from Payless. And Payless ain't even in business no more. But that's gonna be working for this today. Hopefully all of this can come together and be cool. So yeah, I'm about to let you see how it all came together, but the look is inspired by Aaliyah in the resolution video, but I tried to use the music for that. YouTube blocked it, but so I used some music from the Queen of the Damned soundtrack that she was in that movie too, since it fit the theme. So I'm gonna show you what I did with that look, and then we'll get into this next look, which is a totally different vibe. But yeah, this was something different for me. Yeah, I know I like music a lot. And so I actually, while editing, found the song that Timbaland sampled to create the resolution song for Aaliyah. And so I figured I'd stick that in here because I thought that was really cool. That was the classical music you've been hearing in the background so far. And yeah, so check this out before I show you the look. All right, but you gotta settle for this little Kip Beat remake right quick. And like I say, a little Queen of the Damned soundtrack. But I'm about to show you this look right now before we get into the disco look. As I put my little DJ hat on, Tina E. Remix.
Hey! So the first look I did was like a dark gothic look inspired by Liv. And so this one is going to be like a 70s disco funk type of look. So this should be fun. And so yeah, y'all just stay tuned. And everything will be in the description box.
So before we get into the makeup portion for this look, just showing you what I did for the styling. I got the jumpsuit costume from Fashion Nova. It's called Groovy Lady. And you know, the earrings and some more stuff. So check it out.
And so yeah, I'm realizing that it actually comes with the wig too. So as I'm opening it up, it's actually in there. And I got a small medium because even though I'm bottom heavy, I'm fairly small at the top. So, we're sleeving not to put it on, but yeah. This is the actual wig that comes in there. And this is the material. Ooh, pretty. So, yep, it's got the jumpsuit in there, the wig. And the belt and wrist cuffs. All that goes on the wrist. That's the belt. That's the belt. And then from Amazon, I just got some cheap little personal nails. The color look like it'll match. Well, nobody wearing them long claw nails back then in the 70s. So it looks pretty authentic, I guess. They just look a little big. I hope they fit. You'll see. And some huge hoop earrings from Fashion Nova as well. So we'll see how it all looks on. And I guess I will try both wigs.
Now, this the Afro wig that came with the actual Groovy Lady costume from Fashion Nova. I've definitely seen better, but it does come with a wig. This is just how it's looking coming straight out the pack. You just have to fluff it out, you know, with your fingers or whatever. Yeah, no ma'am. I may use this wig for a different 70s makeup look, but honey, yeah, this gonna take some work. And I'm glad I bought a wig to go with this look instead of using this one. Because, I mean, I already have an Afro wig, and this definitely feels cheap and costumey. But it's all good, though. If you need it, it does come with one, so that's good. Just fluff it out. I may just use it for something else. I'll just say I'm glad that I bought a wig, period.
So yeah, this is the wig that I have on in the intro that, you know, I ordered it before I realized that my costume had a wig in there. But I'm glad I did, like I say, but it's a synthetic wig. They make it in brown and black, and it's kind of giving more of that Farrah Fawcett type of hair. It is pretty, you know, but it's not a lace front or anything, but it's fine for the costume. So I'll show you how it looks outside of the pack.
And this is how the wig looks outside of the box. And a part is in the middle, but me, I return to the side because I'm more of a side part kind of girl. So, yes, do as you will, even though that side is funny. So, if you want to cut it or play around with it, but it definitely gives you, you know, that old school 70s style or this woof cut or whatever y'all see going around, kind of reminiscent of that. But, you know, of course, you can play with it. They have it in black as well as brown. This is brown. And get it how you want it. Even though it's not like a lace front or anything, so if you're expecting that, no. But since this hairstyle is usually kind of big anyways, you usually don't see a defined part in there. But, you know, of course they have some that's lace front style if that's what you want. But just so you can see how this looks, this is how it looks.
So this is the top and the front view of the wig. You got the side view. You got the back view of the wig. And you got the other side of it.
And then flipping it inside out is made like that on the inside. So It does not have any clips or anything like that.
It does come with like a knit cap and two clips though. So
I guess that's what you're going to have to use as a clip, but it's not sewed into the cap. Yeah, like I say, if you're expecting a lace front and all that, it ain't that, but you know, it'll work just for a little costume play wig.
Okay, so a lot of the 70s looks had a very shimmery type of look to it.
Which is exemplified in just a side-by-side comparison of the looks of the 60s and the 70s. It seems like everything repeats itself every 20 years. So even the 60s, if you know, 60 years from now, divide, you know, that's 20s, increments of 20s. And if you see in the 2020s, the graphic liners indicative of the 60s did come back. So again, that kind of proves that theory to be true. And they've gotten really creative though, so they've even taken it up a notch, so it's really cool. But yeah, so that's the difference in the mod 60s look and the 70s. It's more sparkle or glowy and metallic colors. It's more cheek color. It's more you know, you could just tell right here where it's not the dark crease anymore and the huge lashes. I mean, you still have lashes, but they're not, you know, like they were. It's a more colorful lip instead of a pale lip and more blush. So, you know, and this is something I got a link in the description box too. It's really cool. Just talking about the different color palettes. And there's even a difference in a day versus a night look for the 70s as well, because they kind of moved away from the very, very dramatics, especially in the daytime for the 70s. It was just a more tan, athletic look, glowing skin, and just very simple and effortless, like these pictures that you see above, which is very different than what we were just seeing in the 60s with all the intense graphic liners and dramatic lashes and stuff. But again, that's what we saw mostly for the daytime look. But especially as you start moving towards the more night, the disco looks or the funk looks, the lips went back to a more red lip and pinks and corals. Especially how I said that stuff repeats itself every 20 years. And if you think Marilyn Monroe era in the 50s, 20 years prior to the 70s, where the red classic lip was a big thing. And so that came back. And so yeah, just check it out. And I see a lot of blue eyeshadow and red lips. That looks pretty big for the 70s. And you can see that's amongst various races, because you know how African Americans, we had fashion fair, and you seeing that same blue eye, red lip or berry lip on us too, even back then. Which I think that little sample kit from Fashion Fair is actually really cute, and wish they still had that. I remember the foundation used to be so red and used to come off on everything, so I'm glad they changed the formulation. And I know my grandma's favorite lip color for years has been Cherry Jubilee. I can't remember if that's Fashion Fair or Avon, but it was both. Yeah, they did have variations, especially when you saw the editorial or, you know, performers and stuff like that. But especially upon doing my research and looking at these pictures, it looks like the default look is the blue eye and the red or pink lip. And the looks was more metallic and shimmery in comparison to the day looks. And the lips, you know, more glossy or dewy. And so yeah, this is the color palette, you know, like I showed previously, that you mostly saw from the 70s, as well as a description of some of the characteristics of the makeup. The link for this article is in the description box, because like I said, it was very interesting. But it's definitely just talking about how the shimmers were popular, the L-shaped rouge that I was talking about, the black mascara and eyeliner, the lashes were more dramatic in the evening in comparison to the daytime look, although it's probably not as dramatic as the 60s. So check that out. And so these are some of my favorites. I was very inspired from those spike lashes and the Farrah Fawcett hair, as well as Chaka Khan and Foxy Brown, you know, Pam Grier, all of those beautiful women. So yeah, this is a difference in the 70s daytime look and the 70s more night or evening look, where you get into the disco, like I say, and the funk and the jumpsuits. So it still was a vast difference in their day and night look. So, yeah. the 70s. Here you go. You get to see that in comparison to my little drawing over there and share. So that'll be the inspiration for today's look.
And so my outfit is hot pink and gold. So I am going to, I'm going to do my eyes gold and then the lips pink. First, I was thinking I was going to do a reverse, but no, I think I'm just going to settle on doing it that way and add a little pink in there. And I've already done my foundation and contouring and all of that. So I did Graftopian in the HD cream as well as the Airbrush foundation. And excuse my voice, y'all. I feel like I'm losing my voice. I drank some tea, but it still sounds a little bit raspy. So excuse that. So here we go. I'm going to start with my Jackie Aina palette. I'm going to do this. Is a Dwala. I'm liking that. Okay, so I'm going to use that same blush color that I use on my eyes, on my cheeks, and make it more defined looking.
What's happening? I'm Treble Lady T. I've heard a boatload of other ladies rap, but they ain't got nothing on me. I'm less than 5'1", 100 pounds a foot. I like sophisticated funk. I live on Don Quixote, heavy off in the mignon, and you can best believe that funk. Here's what I'm talking about.
Definitely stronger than what I would normally do, but you know, 70s and 80s, they definitely went hard with the blush, so that's that. And then just take some gold from here and dab it in both of these and just kind of go over that blush and up here, just give it that golden color. And also, I'm gonna take some of this and mix those in and kind of contour that blush a bit more. See? Yeah, bring it in right there. And make that stand out. Okay, I'm liking it. Got a gold liner. I put some dark brown under my eyes, but on the waterline, I'm gonna put a little gold. Make that stand out. Okay. Now these lashes. You know how 70s lashes are more spiky and sit up like that. So I'm gonna try that. I don't ever use it, but it's some kind of 5D mink lash, 516. A lot of times lash lines have similar number styles, but it's from something called Retro Dress. That's what they say. It was courtesy. It's hard to see. Alright, y'all. I'm gonna put these lashes on off camera. Y'all, I got them on. I cut them into 3 sections and put them on like that, and it helped a lot. But look, y'all, it definitely gives that 70s vibe. Oh my gosh. I'd never do lashes like this, but this is definitely 70s. And I'm thinking I'm gonna even put some on the bottom because I've had this in my kit for a long time. Hey, some bottom lashes, and I think I might try them today. But first, I'm gonna add a little bit of liquid liner on the tail end at the top, just a little bit. And you can draw some bottom lashes too. I struggle enough trying to put the lashes on the top. I'm not finna keep bothering with the bottom. Just put some mascara on and call it a day. I was making it harder than it had to be. Some mascara. Put that on and be done with it. Let me put this other lash on. Alright, so I cut it in 3s and I'm gonna try to put this on camera for y'all. So lips, I'm gonna do pink. I'm gonna use this lip pencil I got in Lolita. Looks like this color. And Maxi and the Ruby Kisses Forever Matte liquid lipstick as the base. And then the gloss on top. I'm gonna do it like a pinky gold, so I'm debating which girls to get. I'll see how it looks when I put it on. We'll be right back. Now, I'm going to put something over it. I want it to be like a gold pink. So I'm going to try this. This is like a pink gold from Pony Effect. I've seen me use that before. It's glossy, but I need a little bit more something. It's from Nana Coco Professional, some from the hair store. It's called Gold Crown. I'm gonna try that.
So good to me, then send me down memory lane. Now, one thing about a lot of the older vintage songs is the music, the live music, the bands. Yes, I miss that a lot, and it sounds so good. It just really sent me down memory lane thinking about my school, you know, in the band. So it's prompted a little halftime, well, end time show, I guess, because it's the end. So enjoy this right quick because we're right at the end of this look. My alma mater, Jackson State University, class of 2004. Yes, that is me. They sent me my alumni shirts back. I ordered that back March or April, and they just got here in November. It didn't even come in October like they said during homecoming week. But it brings me to the battle of the bands. Oh my gosh, just hearing all them horns and everything, man, we used to get it on this song, on a lot of other songs too. But yes, our Sonic Boom of the South ain't nothing to play with, okay? And then the Prince and Jay sets, yes, I love to watch them. If y'all remember that show Bring It, that is actually in Jackson, Mississippi, where the school, it actually was right around the corner, because it would have started in 2001, and I remember that new building, I just didn't really know, you know. But either way, yes, people love to watch the Prince and Jay sets. And so 1971 makes 50 years this year from when they started, so I'm about to show a little love to Jackson State right quick, okay? Do a little highlight right quick before I get into this highlight. Yes, I love that high kick sequence when they turning that corner on that ramp coming to them stands. Yes. But yeah, Get Ready was another one that would get us hyped. This clip from 2002 when I used to go there. Thank you. See, now you get to see for yourself what the Sonic Boom of the South and the Prince J sets do next. Shouts out, especially just doing the 70s look. Oh, they be getting in the stands, honey. That's what I miss about a HBCU. Yes, country bred and fed, all right? But yeah, so happy 50th anniversary. Those songs just brought back memories. They are classics. Hope you enjoyed this halftime / end time show. And yeah, let's get back to this makeup. This the end of it now, y'all.
Little highlight. So I end up using Maxi and I deepened it with this gold and a gloss. So combination of cute. You can kind of see a little bit more clue. And so yeah, that's these. And then I look alright, y'all. Alright, let me spray my setting spray. Then the final seal. Yeah, y'all. Kind of see it. Oh yeah, this gonna look good with my costume, which you can wear it even if it's not a costume if you want to, you know? But yeah. You guys for watching. I hope you enjoy the video and the look. If you like the video, please like and subscribe. All the links are in the description box, and stay tuned for more. Bye.